Very good morning to all of you. Good morning, all my dear friends. So today we are going to discuss a very small topic, and in the next class we will finish this topic. So the topic is viewing pipelining and coordinate system. What is a viewing pipelining and what is a coordinate system? Let me discuss. So first of all, what is viewing pipelining? Let me have a look. So the term viewing pipelining, describes a series of transformation which are passed by geometry data to end up an image data being displayed on a device. I hope you understand this theoretical notation. So I just explain with the help of example. Suppose nowadays there is IPL matches will start in soon. So in the ground, we have lots of, we can say, big space, a big, we can say, ground in a cricket ground. And there are lots of players and lots of public. Normal days, I'm talking about the normal days. So with the help of camera, we capture a particular, we can say, scene in that real world. And that scene is then transferred, or we can say scaled or transformed to the 2D plane. 2D plane, it means that whole 3D image or whole world real image is captured. Whole, it means a particular portion from that whole world. We will capture a particular area from that whole world into the camera, and that camera, what did the camera? Simply convert that whole big image into the our display size. Suppose you are viewing that match into your mobile, suppose you are watching the match on your we can say television, suppose you are watching your match into the suppose projector. So according to the display device, the size of an image is vary. It means suppose you are watching on a mobile, then whole things will be minimized according to the display size. It means mobile size or a TV size or a projector size. So that conversion from real world clipping window, it means the scene which you are selecting from the real world, it's simply known as a on the window, and that window is transferred to the particular display device coordinate system, that is simply called viewport. I hope you're understanding. I don't know you understanding not. Let me explain it. So what is a window? The method of selecting and enlarging a portion of a drawing is called windowing. The area chosen for this displaying is called the window. The window is selected by the word coordinate. See, there is a match and we select a special portion like a betting of a particular player, then the scene which we are going to select, that particular player scene, is simply known as a window, because there are lots of other scene but we are selecting only the particular scene, that is simply known as a window. Sometimes we are interested in some portion of an object and not in full object. Suppose there is a scenery, a big scenery, but we want to show only small part of that, so that is small part is simply known as a window in the real world. So we will decide on a imaginary box. This box will enclose desired or interested area of an object. Such an imaginary box is called a window. I have an example for that. I just explain it after, then we will move to the next things. So it is a window. This window, we can say it is a live match commentary. In this live match commentary, it is whole match ground, cricket ground, and we are selecting only a particular portion to display. So that particular portion which we are selecting, that imaginary portion, is simply known as a window. So it is a word coordinate, real word coordinate. We choose that real word coordinate in the particular this window, and this window is displayed on our mobile or on our TV or on a projector. So where we display, that is simply known as a viewport. What we say, it is a viewport. So it is simply called a viewport, where we are viewing the word choose image, and that image is chosen according to the window. With the help of this window, we choose a particular scene from the real world. So what is a viewport? An area on display device to which a window is mapped, where it is to be displayed. So if you are displayed the image on your phone, that the phone window is known as a viewport, or TV size is known as a viewport, or projector size is simply known as a viewport. I hope you are understanding. So what happens when we are capturing the image from real world and we are displaying that image into the 2D system, because our TV and mobiles are the 2D systems, that is simply whole transformation is called a viewing pipelining. Pipelining, it means one after another, piece by piece, we are converting the real world image into the 2D image. So there are some steps, there are some standard steps. So what are the steps? Construct the world coordinate scene using the modeling coordinates transformation. So it is a world coordinate. So world coordinate means, suppose it is a window and the window size is X, world minimum, X world coordinate maximum, Y world coordinate minimum, Y coordinate maximum. So it is a real world size. Now convert the world coordinate into the view coordinate. Suppose this size may be in the kilometer and maybe in the meter. We want to convert into the some small size. Suppose in inches, or suppose maybe a millimeter or something like that. So we convert that real world size into scale according to our device, which is simply known as converting the world coordinate to the view coordinate. Then transferring the view coordinate to the normal coordinate. So we simply transfer that particular view coordinate into the normal coordinate system, which is our 2D system. Mapping normalized coordinate to the device coordinate. The our device, we simply map according to the device system. So it is a view coordinate. View, it means where we are viewing. So it is simply the portion which we are want to display. It is a viewport. It is a whole real things. We convert into the viewport. It is a normally viewport system. Both are same thing. Okay. Both are same thing. But here it's representing the window, a world coordinate, and it is a divide coordinate. So which simply want to convert the world coordinate system into the divide coordinate system. In doing that, we simply map that real world image into the a 2D image on our display. I hope you are understanding. Now there are some transformation. What is a transformation? We want to convert window port into the viewport. It is also containing some mathematical expression, little bit expression, that is hard. So we will continue that expression into the next class. So today we are simply, I am introducing the things. A window viewport transformation describes the mapping of a rectangular window into the one coordinate system into the another rectangle window is called another coordinate system. So the real world coordinate system are converted into the 2D coordinate system. So one coordinate system it converted into the another coordinate system is simply called a window to viewport transformation. This transformation is defined by the selection of the original image that is transformed, clipping window. Clipping window, it means the window will contain only the interesting part, or other part is it clipped. The location of the resulting window viewport and how the window is translate scalar rotation. Definitely, suppose you are collecting the image in some other position, some we can say at particular angle or something like that, and we have to be converted that image into the 2D image in the stable form. Stable form, it means the horizontal vertical form like that. So friends, today we are discussing only something like what is a window, what is a viewport, and the window is simply an imaginary screen which we are selecting to capture the image, and what is a viewport, a display device where we are displaying the particular image or particular scene which we are selecting on our display. Particular display like TV, like mobile, like projector, something like that. And translation, transformation, it means we converting the whole big image into the our device image, and that transformation contains the series of pipelining I show in the previous slide, series of pipeline operations, and that we are doing by using a transformation. Transformation, it means we applying the scaling, or we applying the translation, or we are applying the we can say rotation, scaling, translation, sharing, reflection, so many things we will apply. So thank you friend, I hope you understand this topic. We will continue the next topic in the next class. Thank you very much.